Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about entomology crop wise pest classification. So I am going to cover the topic pest of mustards. So as usual, the first one is the name of the common name of the insect, and the second one is scientific name, and the third column is the family, and the fourth one is order. So first we are going to see about the diamondback moth. So where the scientific name is Plutella xylostella, and the symptom of damage. So the first symptom is scraping of the epidermal leaf tissues by the larva is the first major symptom of diamondback moth, and it also bores into the pods and feeds the developing seeds. These are the major symptoms we must need to know in the diamondback moth. And while seeing about their identification as well as their biology, so egg which is said to be yellow colored eggs, which used to placed or laid in the upper surface of the leaves, and the egg period is 2 to 6 days, and the larva which is said to be a palish green color larva, brownish at their anterior end, and the larval period is 14 to 21 days based on the climatic changes, and the pupa where the pupation which used to occur in the transparent cocoon. So you can able to see that in this picture where they used to have a yellow body, but it also covered with a transparent whitish transparent cocoon, and the adult which is said to be a small grayish black moth, so which used to show the appearance or else the resemblance of diamond shaped markings, which used to have fringe wings with a long hair. So these are the classification as well as identification of these diamondback moth. So these are some other identifications. So the management practices we can able to move for the diamondback moth are installing pheromone traps at the ratio of 12 per hectare is used to effectively monitor this moth, and also we must need to conserve the parasitoids which can be able to control them in the field level, and also we must need to collect and carefully destruction of the larva at the gregarious stage at least twice a week is an effective one against the diamondback moth, or else we must need to control of grown up larva by applying 5% Malathion dust at 37.5 kg per hectare, or else we can also apply 925 ml chloripyrifos in 600 to 700 liter of water per hectare. So these are the chemical methods which you use to control diamond head moth. And the next important insect in mustard is leaf webber, where the scientific name is Crocidolomia binostalis, and the symptom of damage where the newly hatched larva which used to feed instantly the chlorophylls of the leaves, so which used to later at the older stage which used to also fully defoliate the leaves, buds as well as pods, and also make the web picks, and which used to live within it. So these are the symptoms of the leaf webber, and in several cases which used to cause defoliation in the leaves, and seeds in the pods are also eaten away by the leaf webber is an important cause in mustard. So the identification of this leaf webber is larva which is said to be a palish yellow brown with a series of lateral and sublateral black spots and as well as specks. So adult is an yellowish brown color moth, and in forewing you can able to see the there is a black tuft of hair near the thorax, and in hindwings there is a white with a dark brown apical area is the identification for this moth. So the effective management against the leaf webber is spraying of insecticides at anyone like Pospolon at 35 EC at 2 ml per liter, or else Fenvirate at 20 EC at 0.5 ml per liter is an effective manage against exchange leaf webber. So the next one is cabbage headed borer, where the scientific name is Helulla undalis, and the symptom of damage they use it to mine the leaves, and it is used to leaves a whitish papery in the leaves, and the larva later used to feed on the leaves which use also used to bore into the stem and also make an entrance holes which is said to be covered with silk as well as the excreta made by these insects. So the cabbage head borer, so we can able to identify this pest with the larva which is said to be whitish brown with color with 4 to 5 or pinkish brown longitudinal stripes, and the adult which where the moths are said to be pale grayish brown, so which is said to be stuffed with a reddish color, and the forewings which used to have gray wavy lines, and the hindwings are pale dusky and darker in apical areas. So our its identification we must need, I have already told you about the adult which is said to be pale greenish brown moth with a wavy gray markings, But the egg which is to be laid in groups or else and also in singly under the surface of the leaves, and the pinkish yellow shiny oval in shape, and the larva which is to be fully grown larva which is to be a greenish yellow color, and the pupa which is to takes inside the burrowing of the plants. Once it enters into the stem, it also makes a pupation. So the managementation for these caterpillars are, so the collection and destruction of larva at the gregarious stage, so we must need to effectively check the crop twice a week, and the grown up larva which used to apply 5% malathion dust at 37.5 kg per hectare or carbaryl 50 WP at 375 gram in 150 liter of water is an effective control management. And the next one is mustard sawfly. So the scientific name is Atharia lugens proxima. So the symptom of damage is where the grub is used to cause numerous shoot holes, and which used to cause the entire leaves to be riddled by the voracious feeding of these mustard sawfly is an important symptom in mustard sawfly. So the pictures, it is a picture of mustard sawfly larva. So the caterpillar which is said to be with a wrinkled body and the prolix or without crotchets is an important identification we can able to see in the grub. So the larva is said to be a grub type, and the pupa which is used to be pupates in the soil. So these are the dynamics of these mustard sawfly. So the egg which is said to be 12 to 131 eggs are said to be laid by the female in their whole period, and the egg period is around 3 to 6 days. They use it to lay singly on the lower surface of the leaves is the characteristics of the mustard sawfly. And the pupation, where the pupal situation is said to be taking 4 to 6 instars, and the pupation also occur in soil with the clusters. And the adult, while seeing about the characteristics of adult for its identification, they use it to have a dark head and thorax, and they also have a orange colored abdomen. And around they used to have a smoky wings, which is a translucent smoky wings with the black veins are present on their wings. So these are the life cycle pictures of mustard sawfly. So the management, best management for mustard sawfly is summer plowing to destroy the pupa, and early sowing can be done, which used to help the plant to effectively escape from the mustard sawfly, and the collection and destruction of grubs of sawfly in morning and evening. And also we can able to use bitter gourd seed oil emulsion as an antifeedant in the crop. And as a final one, we can able to move for the crop with the chemical sprayings like malathion 50 EC at 1000 ml per hectare, or quinalpos 25 EC at 625 ml per hectare is an effective one. And all this should be applied in about 600 to 700 liters of water per hectare. And the next one is mustard aphids, where the scientific name is Lipapis erysimi. So the symptom of damage, so the mustard aphid, where the both nymph and adult used to suck the plant from the leaves, buds and pods, so they which may cause a curling infestation of the leaves at the advanced stages, which and in advanced stages it may lead the plant to wither and the whole plant can able to die. And it also used to makes a honeydew secretion by the insects sucking type, which used to gave a way for secondary infections like sooty mold in the plant, and the infected flies look sickly and brightened in appearances. So for the identification of these aphids, the aphids are said to be small soft body pale shaped insects which used to have a pair of cornicles and projecting out from the fifth or sixth abdomen segment. So the favorable seasons for the aphid attack are the aphids used to attack generally during the second and third week of December, and which used to continue till March. And the most favorable climate for these aphids are between 8 and 24 degrees centigrade, and they used to show an humidity of around 70 to 80% of humidity, where the multiplication of aphids also faster. And even in rainy and humid temperature, the acceleration of the growth of aphid insects are said to be higher than other climate conditions. So we can able to make the management practices in aphids with the use of tolerant varieties like JM1 and RK9501, and also we can able to grow sown the crop before 20th October, which used to escape the damage of this these aphids. And we must also need to use yellow stick trap to monitor aphid population and We must also need to consider the natural enemies like ladybirds and adult beetles, which used to feed on these aphids. And we can also relate Braconid parasitoids, which is a very useful biocontrol agent for the mummification of the aphids in the field level. So as a final one, we can able to go for the use of chemical pesticides like oxodomethane, methyl as well as dimethoate at 625 to 1000 ml per hectare is an effective one for controlling these aphids. And the next one is painted bug, where the scientific name is Burgreda hilaris. So they use it to attack young plants and wilt and wither as the result of attack, which use and the adult bugs which use it to excrete a resinous substance which use it to spoil the pods present in the mustard. So the, for the identification of pet, these pest adult, which is a bug, is black in color with red and yellow marginal lines on their wings. So the management is deploying, which is used to show the eggs of the painted bugs, which can be destroyed, and early sowing is needed to avoid these pest attack. And we can also go for the quick threshing of harvested crops can be done, so which is able to reduce the infestation of painted bug in the storage grounds. And we can also able to spray the crops with the Malathion 50 EC at 1000 ml, or else dimethoate 30 EC at 625 ml in 600 to 700 liters water, or indosulfone 4% is an effective one in the management practices of the painted bug in mustard. So I have given the lecture notes in description. So comment about the video and join us in the Instagram page. If you like the video, like it and share it with your friends, and subscribe to BC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up next videos.